Well, hey, y'all. JM out here at the ranch. Let me get it unholstered. I'm out here with Colt's Government Model 45 automatic caliber. Now, let me get this unloaded, and then I'm going to talk to you about it a little bit, and then we'll go over to the range and shoot it. Okay, we're unloaded, so let's talk a little bit about this Government Model of Colt. This is not the 1911 of John Browning back in 1911, 1912, when it took the government contract all the way through to the mid-late 80s when the Beretta M9 took over. It's also not the 1911 of 1924 when its designation changed to the 1911 A1 with a few exterior modifications done. In 1981, Colt came out with their 80 series. There were something like 20 models in that 80 series. The government model is one of them. Now, this specific gun is not even of that decade. The 80 series added a firing pin lock that prevented the gun from going off if it was dropped, so it made the 1911 drop safe. In 1991, Colt gave in to market pressure and economized the Series 80 government model. They, instead of having the nice buff finish, they went to a matte finish, a plastic trigger, also didn't round off the edges as nicely, so they economized it so that they could compete with the more inexpensive 1911s of other companies. Problem one, people didn't buy that. When you went to buy Colt 1911, people wanted a quality Colt gun. Didn't mind buying an economized model from other companies, but not from Colt. So within a couple of years, Colt had to uneconomize and go back to the government model that they had before. So what they did, they took that M1991 A1 designation off of it, put the government model 45 automatic caliber that you're seeing on this gun, went back to the buff finish, went back and rounded off the edges, and put the anodized aluminum trigger on it. So they also, one thing is they changed the grips back to the rosewood grips. That even made rubber grips out of that economized model. Now we've got more of the quality 1911 that people wanted from their Colt. So as I stated, this gun here is not the original 1911 or the 1911 A1 or the original Series 80 or even the M1991 A1. It is the newer version of that 1991. So I'm simply going to call this the Government Model 1911 Colt. So this is the Government Model 40 ounces, 5-inch barrel, 1911 from Colt, and I think the best way to show you this gun is to actually go through the function of it, and in doing so, I'll go through the safety mechanisms as well as how John Browning harnessed those gases to make the lock breech gun work. All right, well, first of all, we're empty, so all of this is pretend. So what we're going to do is we're going to chamber around. Safety up. This is the carry position of the gun. We've got our slide lock safety in a position where the slide is locked and the trigger cannot be pulled with the safety up. So what we have is we've got a round chambered with a barrel and the slide locked in the full forward position. What this has done, when we're carrying it like this, it has the disconnector involved so that with the slide locked with the barrel, the disconnector will allow the sear to drop and the hammer to fire. If the slide is not locked with the barrel, and if the chambered round is not in place correctly, then the disconnector will not allow the sear to fall and will not allow the gun to fire. So we're in the carry position right now. So let's unholster, and we're going to get in a defensive situation. What do we do with the gun at this point? We come off with our slide lock safety. As we've done that, we've got our disconnector allowing the sear to fall, we're ready to go. Let's see if this works. Trigger. Trigger will not pull because we also have a grip safety. The grip safety on the 1911, there's a block behind the trigger. When it's mashed, the block is removed and the trigger will fire. So we're in position now, ready to fire the gun. At this point, all the safeties we've talked about are ready to allow the sear to go, the hammer to fall. But what if we drop the gun? So we accidentally drop it, the hammer hits, falls forward accidentally, will the gun fire? With the 1980 series, as I said, Colt added the firing pin lock. It will not fire unless the triggers pull. So you can drop the gun, the hammer can fall, it won't matter. Firing pin block prevents the firing pin from hitting the primer. Okay, as we get ready to fire the gun, we've got our grip safety, deactivated the block behind the trigger as we've mashed it. At this point, our firing pin block safety is still activated, and it will deactivate as we pull the trigger. As the triggers pull, an instant after this firing pin safety drops, the sear will drop, allow the hammer to fall, and the gun fires. All right, John Browning, step in and help us out a little bit here. As the bullet exits the barrel, the slide's on its way back with the barrel still intact. When the pressure is at a safe limit, the barrel will disengage from the slide, the lock breech situation. The slide will continue backward. It'll have the extracted case. Then it will eject the case. The slide will continue backward all the way to the back against the recoil spring. Then the recoil spring will slam it back into battery. As it goes back, it'll grab around, take it right back into the chamber, lock the barrel, and lock the slide together. So the disconnector will now once again allow the sear to allow the hammer to fall, and we're ready to go again. All right, two more things before we head out to the range to shoot this gun. One, it does not have a magazine disconnect safety. Okay, a lot of military guns don't, because they don't want the gun to be inactive if the magazine accidentally falls out. No magazine disconnect safety. The second thing that it has, don't confuse this with a hammer partially cocked like you have in the Beretta. But what this gun has, if you're going to cock the hammer manually and you slip, look what happens. There's a partial cock. It really is not. This is called a hammer stop, not a partial cock. This is something that's not to be ever done manually like in the Beretta when you have cock. This is simply a hammer stop that prevents the hammer from hitting the firing pin in case there's a slippage of it. Okay, you can disengage this by pulling the trigger. And Colt states that there's not enough pressure there to fire the gun, but I'm certainly not going to give that a shot. So that is simply a safety mechanism that allows the hammer to be stopped so that you don't have an accidental fire. So y'all, what makes this 1911 so popular in a gun that shooters like me really like? Well, is it all of this disconnecting and firing pin blocks and things? Heck no. Most people don't even know any of that exists, and most don't even care if that exists. What makes this gun so great is the trigger. So let me show you the action on this trigger. Okay, we're locked and loaded, no rounds in it. First of all, with the trigger, it is a single action only trigger. Meaning, all it does is release the sear and allow the hammer to fall, okay? There is no double action. There is not a decocker. When the hammer's down, it does not cock and fire by the trigger. It's single action, gun only. So let me show you what it looks like as we prep the trigger. That's all the prep that there is. There is literally no take up or prep to worry about. Then as you start back, boy, Jeff Cooper likes this deal. Jeff Cooper surprise break. No way with this 1911 you're going to have any idea when it went off until you hear the bullet hit your target or see it hit the target. So it's a beautiful, very easy to control trigger. It measures by me at 6 pounds, 2 ounces on the Lyman trigger puller. The other things from the shootability of the gun, obviously for me, this is number one. Number two and three and four are balance. It has a 105 degree angle of the grip that's supposed to be ideal, and boy, it feels ideal. Well balanced in hand, and then it has triple dot sights. Those are my favorite. Very easy to get your sight alignment with it. I'll tell y'all, there's nothing much else to do with this gun but get out to the range. So follow me over to the range and let's see how it shoots. Okay y'all, let's do what we came out here to do. Let's go ahead and lock and load. This time, we're for really locked and load. Okay, while we talk just a second, get my thumb safety up, which prevents the trigger and the slide from doing anything. Get our side alignment out there nicely. Let's see what we've got. You know, this little gun's maiden voyage here. So let's see how it feels to shoot this little guy. Okay, gonna have a 6 pound trigger. Almost no recoil. That's the beauty of a 40 ounce, well balanced gun. 45 caliber As you could see, I'm sitting here 40, 45 feet, and I'm putting all of those right in the same spot with ease. Now, I'm not that great, I'm an average shot, but with this gun, it is so easy to maintain those sights on target because every single shot is a surprise. I had no idea any time I was about to pull the trigger when it was going to fire. This is a beautifully balanced, very easy to accurately shoot 45 caliber 1911. Okay, let's move out now, locked and loaded at 40 yards. Try to hold those sights, get my surprise break. Very easy. That's 40 yard shot. I'm not just sitting here doing a lot of holding and aiming, just pretty much putting it on target and firing. Well, you know, y'all, I've had the pleasure of shooting a fair number of 1911 variants from other companies, and a lot of them I like, but not any better than this one. This little gun's maiden voyage, right out of the box today. The government model Colt 1911. Beautifully balanced, beautifully filling gun, very easy to hold target with it. Trigger control is as good as it gets. You know, if you want a 1911, you like a little history. Now, no, this isn't the 1911 1911. This isn't the 1911 A1 1911. This is our modern version, but it's still a Colt. It's still a Colt, and it is a great filling gun. Thanks y'all for viewing our videos. We really appreciate it. Hope to see you around at Real Guys Reviews. If you have a chance, check out our Colt Government Model 1911 Field Strip video.